The Philippine poll body asserts the conduct of the 2023 Village and Youth Council elections was better than the previous editions of the BSKE polls. Meanwhile, the COMELEC issues a statement on the controversial withdrawal of a number of school teachers from poll duty. Victoria Tula joins us with those stories. Hi, Victoria. What can you tell us?
Hi, Stanley. COMELEC Chairman George Garcia said in a press conference today that they will not file cases against teachers who withdrew from serving on Election Day itself. He called these teachers heroes and said that they just want to investigate their reason for backing out, particularly if they were threatened to avoid this from happening again. Who they will go after are those who threatened the teachers. As for administrative cases, it will be up to the Department of Education to file against teachers if this is warranted. Cops who withdrew on Election Day is a different story. Filing of criminal cases may still be possible depending on their reason. Garcia previously said that some PNP personnel who were supposed to take the place of teachers in the electoral board suddenly withdrew. Meanwhile, Garcia described the 2023 Village and Youth Council polls as better compared to previous village elections. He said it was orderly from the election period, which started from the filing of certificates of candidacy on August 28 to Election Day on October 30. Although there were some incidents of delay and violence, elections are still peaceful and manageable since just a few of the 42,001 villages nationwide experienced problems. Garcia also pointed out the successful implementation of their three pilot projects: the early voting for pregnant voters, senior citizens, indigenous peoples, and persons with disability. There's also the mall voting and automated elections in three villages. The poll chief now reminds candidates, even those who withdrew, to file their statements of contributions and expenditures, or SOSE, 30 days after the elections. This is to avoid being fined and disqualified from holding public office. Candidates also need to take down their campaign posters and other campaign materials by tomorrow to not be charged with an election offense. Garcia points out that election period is until November 29, so they still have jurisdiction. The gun ban is still in effect and there are still checkpoints. He also clarified that proclamation of all candidates are not 100% yet, since there are still ties in Region 6. These candidates who have ties need to draw lots or to do a coin toss within the day. Stanley?
All right, Victoria Tula there. Thank you. The Philippine poll body begins preparations for the special elections in Negros Oriental that will determine the replacement for expelled lawmaker Arnolfo Teves Jr. Annie Perez joins us with that story. Hi, Annie.
Yes, Tani, that's right. The Commission on Elections here in Central Visayas, its regional director, Attorney Lionel Castellanos, said that they have not received any advisory that the special elections for the third district representative will be postponed, so they are continuing their preparations. The elections are set on December 9, and this election is set for the selection of the new third district representative after former Congressman Anisa Tevez was expelled from the House of Representatives. Tevez is also facing murder charges for the death of former Negros Oriental Governor Ruel Digamo and is tagged as the mastermind. Castellano adds they are still awaiting final guidelines from their head office, but they're already preparing the forms to be used for the filing of certificate of candidacy, which is slated on Monday. This is based on the recent COMELEC resolution 10945, which gave all the calendar of activities for the special elections. We also requested the Philippine National Police to guard their office as aspirants and their supporters were trooped to the provincial office of COMELEC Negros Oriental on Monday. So the part of the Negros Oriental Provincial Police Office are already ready in securing the COMELEC office for Monday. As of now, they're also drafting the security plan for the special elections. Police Lieutenant Stephen Solinar, the spokesperson of the Negros Oriental Provincial Police Office, said but they are also waiting for the final guidelines and instructions from COMELEC, but they're also drafting the security plan for the special elections. He also adds that they're awaiting the revival of the Provincial Crowd Security Control Center that terminated its meetings after the barangay and Siguning and Kabataan elections. The period for the filing of certificates of candidacy will run until Wednesday, November 8th. Meanwhile, the election period will commence a day after on November 9th and will end on December 24. The province of Negros Oriental still remains to be under COMELEC control, since the village and youth council polls last Monday. That's the latest news from Central Visayas. Annie Perez, ABS News.
All right. Annie, have you spoken to any of those who are intending to run? And what sense are you getting as far as security is concerned? Do they feel safe?
Actually, Stanley, there are no definite answers yet. We'll be running the bill. Third time in former Governor Roel De Gama's camp that some of his allies are running. We did not hear yet from the Tebas camp if they are fielding anybody. But from the other camp, we heard that there might be two who might be running against each other. But these are not definite yet until we would know who will be filing their certificate of candidacy on Monday. But as for security-wise, we talked to COMELEC's provincial director, Lionel Pasoliano, and he said that the number of PNP personnel and even the military who are still in Negros Oriental since the barangay and SK elections are still there, and they are definite that they will be able to provide enough security, especially that what they will be securing will not only be the 3rd district, but also their office, which is located in the Magyate City. And they're confident that the security they will be providing is enough and will be securing us as the 3 days for the certificate of candidacy will be starting next week. And as the election period, there might be changes on the deployment and how many troops they will be deploying. But Castellano said, despite the lack of guidelines and of final instructions in the head office, they will continue initially to continue.
All right, an update on the upcoming elections in Negros Oriental from Annie Perez. Annie, thank you. Families of victims of involuntary disappearances in the Philippines gather to remember their missing kin. They remain hopeful the so-called desaparecidos are still alive. Vivian Gulia reports.
There was no grave, but family members grieved their loved ones who involuntarily disappeared. On All Souls Day, they gathered at the Bantayog ng Mga Bayani to remember the desaparecidos and reiterate their call for government to help them get closure. Edita Burgos, the mother of missing activist Jonas Burgos, and the group Karapatan urged the administration of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. to address the issue on desaparecidos from the time of his father to the present day.
Not only the closure, but the suspended uncertainty. I think that's it. That's the source of the grief. Hindi mo alam eh. Do we pray that he's alive? If he's gone, alam ko hindi na siya nahihirapan. But I don't want to wish not to see him anymore. But if he's still alive, you know that he's still being tortured. And you wouldn't want that.
Many broke into tears as they lit candles and offered flowers to the photos of their disappeared loved ones. Among them is Nicole, the younger sister of Norman Ortiz, who disappeared just last September.
May mga witness din kami na nagsasabi na dinukot sila ng mga armadong militar. Sa isang buwan, halos araw-araw mong napapag-iniban. Buti pa sa panaginip, nagkita na kami. Hindi naman kami titigil sa paghahanap kasi naniniwala kami na nabuhay pa siya.
It has been over 3 decades since Ligaya's husband, Union Leader Armando Portahada Sr., disappeared in July 1987. But she said her grief has only gotten worse. She explained it is difficult to move on when until today, they still do not know what exactly happened to her husband who only fought for the rights of workers.
Noon ang nagtatanong lang, mga anak ko, Nay, asan si tatay? Ngayon, mga apo na po namin ang nagtatanong sa amin. Dagdag na naman po ng bigat sa dibdib kasi hindi namin maipaliwanag sa kanila kung ano po talaga ang nangyari.
Ligaya offered a poem for her husband, which she delivered during Thursday morning's program.
Hindi na maidlip itong aking diwa, inanap na kita mula nang mawala. Malawak na dagat, aking tinatanaw, pati na ang aloy, aking bililinan, ibalik sa akin. Kahit gula-gulanit na bangkay sa aking kandungan, siya'y aking ihimlay.
Karapatan demanded that the government and its state forces answer all inquiries, open military camps and detention centers, and respond to the plea of families to declare the whereabouts of recent victims of enforced disappearances. Burgos noted that political will is necessary for the implementation of the law against enforced or involuntary disappearance to be effective.
We won our case at Supreme Court, but he was never surfaced and returned to us, even if we had a writ of amparo. So, parang useless. unless there is political will among the top leadership of the country. Useless lang itong mga batas natin.
For many attendees like Edita, Ligaya, and Nicole, the annual All Souls Day gathering of the families of desaparecidos is an opportunity to draw strength from each other in their continuing quest for justice. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.